This is a message to every lovely human being out there. The creators and the users. The wisdom seekers and the teachers. The entrepreneurs and makers. To all the freedom loving people out there. The internet as we know it is about to end. Once again. On May 20th, 2021, the German government passed a law to implement the directive on copyright from the European Union. This law is aimed at digital markets and it requires the platforms such as YouTube, Facebook and Twitter that users are prevented from causing a copyright infringement by uploading any media to their platforms. Up until now, copyright holders were required to flag any copyright infringement by themselves and request a takedown from the corresponding platform. This has changed with the new law, and it's now the platform's responsibility to prevent any copyright infringements. Many experts have warned that such law will not be possible without upload filters, and they are proven right. From August on, platforms are required to implement such filters, and we have been lied right into our faces. The politicians promised us that upload filters will not be required, and even they have written it down in their coalition contract. And yet, we are still getting them. Are you seriously wondering why young people are sick of politics and your approval is declining and declining? But before I continue to explain why this is a very dangerous development, I want to take you on a quick walk and do some real talk. Since this is already my 10th video this year, I wanted to take some time, answer some questions and also make a little announcement on how I'm going to proceed on YouTube. I gotta ask why I always wear a hat. Well, the truth is, I turned 30 in a few months, and to reach such old age, you need to sacrifice something. And for me, it's apparently my hair, which means it's either too cold or too hot, and therefore I need to wear something on my head. And also with all the light in the studio, my head looks like it could summon a werewolf. I also received some questions asking me to share more of the musical stuff I do. The terrible truth is, I'm no good musician and I'm still in the learning process, so there's not a lot to share just right now. You can find my musical stuff under Lumicon, I will link the channel down below, and this will be the place where I will be uploading all my musical content in the future. Go ahead and check it out, I already uploaded my first jam there. And last but not least, I got advice to do my videos in German instead of English. I'm really sorry if my English is not on point from time to time. My native language is German and I very much like to discuss complicated matters in German, and sometimes it's hard for me to translate them back. And that task is even harder if I'm talking to the camera, which is still strange from time to time. Most of you are not from Germany anyway. I identify myself as a European citizen, and the matters and topics I discuss here are not concerns of only Germans or Germany. So I think it matters for everyone. And that's why I'm going to continue making my videos in English, even if I suck sometimes at English. Which brings me back to the copyright directive and upload filter. Here's a quick rundown what happened and what is going to happen before we turn back for a little German and German history lesson. In 1886, a first step towards copyright protection was made. The Bern Convention for the Protection of Literary and Artistic Work is held and defines basic rights for content creators, such as rights for reproduction, communication and distribution. The next major adjustment or development now issued by the European Union was Directive 91-250, over 100 years later. On May 14, 1991, the Computer Programs Directive was enacted in order to deal with rising issues based upon the nature of computer programs.
For the first time in history, an economic good could be copied infinitely by only using electricity. Following up in 2001, the Information Society Directive was enacted to harmonize the different copyright laws across Europe. Seemingly, that was not sufficient enough, so in the following years, different studies were conducted, which ultimately ended with the European Copyright Directive on April 17, 2019. The copyright directive is not completely bad. For example, it allows some good things, such as the usage of copyright-protected content for science, such as machine learning. On the other hand, Article 17 of the directive requires service providers to A. agree on licensing with copyright holders, and B. much worse, use technical measures to prevent and delete any misuse of copyrighted content. However, the enactment of the directive into German law requires upload filters, but it allows a portion of fair usage, which is a mere joke, to be honest. Whoever has written that law has obviously no technical background. You are allowed to use 15 seconds of moving pictures or sounds, 160 characters of text. That's exactly as much as a SMS has, and even less than the tweet promoting this video. And finally, 125 kilobytes of imagery. And seriously, depending on the used algorithm and file format, you can fit way more or way less into a single file.
And before you say that's all conspiracy theory, I want you to have a look at this building right here. Unfortunately, Braunschweig is famous for a very sad part of German history. In 1925, Braunschweig made Hitler a German citizen, allowing him to run for election and ultimately him becoming the worst dictator in history. Despite many attempts to stop Hitler from becoming a German, it was this very building where it ultimately was decided to make him a government official of Braunschweig and thus giving him the German citizenship. There's a German saying, "Wehret den Anfängen." It's originally a Latin saying which translates to warning from bad love, but nowadays it's rather used in the context of warning of bad developments. And oh boy, do we have a bad development here. And again, this is not a German development, it's a worldwide development. If you want to take a glimpse into the future, I highly recommend you to read the book 1985 by George Orwell. Or you just have a look at China, where they are already controlling millions of citizens with technology, censoring, suppressing unwanted opinions, or punishing those who dare to violate the rules. This is a very dangerous development. Effectively, we are getting filters on all major platforms. But what if one day someone decides there is other unwanted types of content we might need to filter out? For example, an unpopular opinion. It can and it will be easily justified. For example, we need to stop fake news, we need to stop racism, or all kinds of other illegal activities. Don't get me wrong here. As a society, we need to find ways and develop strategies against injustice and inequality. But we are a democratic society and we should do everything which is humanly possible to keep this right alive. We need to find other ways to protect the rights of content creators and not install mass surveillance and censoring tools. As I'm editing this video, the German government pulled another one on us. Law enforcement authorities are now allowed to use spyware on you, even with vague suspicion. I can't believe it. I will do my part and I will fight this injustice and will do everything I can to prevent a future that looks like George Orwell described it. If you don't want to miss out on that and want to support my case, consider subscribing. There will be coming more in the future. See you soon. Yeah.